The present exhibition, From Earth to Earth, curated by Julien, literally offers colorful historical glimpses into the unique practice of the devotion-filled terracotta offerings to INR in the state of Tamil Nadu. The Tamil Nadu, the temple state of India, is culturally rich, also in religions, popular by the people, proud of their literary heritage and religious traditions. It is here, perhaps, the concept of the village gods, or INRs, come into practice. INR, the female god, and the male god, which is based on the concept of Vishnu and Shiva, and the goddess such as Mariamma, or fashioned after the woman, in small and simple societies then admired, or the female characters taken from the Puranas. From INRs arose a form of worshipful offering that blossomed into the unique, the stylistic art form. These village gods or deities are flaked by animals, birds, made of terracotta or clay. Here lies the story of beauty, abiding faith, and religion practices that unwittingly becomes a renowned art form. We often see huge, colorful, decorated terracotta horses, bulls, tigers, elephants at INR temples. These images are made by the pottery community, which also runs these INR temples. Over time, these images, small or large, made with love, devotion, crumble and become one with the earth, legitimizing the title of this exhibition. From Earth to Earth. What a great philosophy told so simple to the village, so told by this village folk right from the pre-Vedic times, perhaps. The intricately decorated terracotta exhibits here is the evidence of the artistic talent found in the rural hinterlands of Tamil Nadu, handed down to the generations. This time, the hereditary talent and the occupation is also a matter of concern today, because we wonder how many among the younger generations are involved in continuing with this tradition. Are the INR terracotta offerings is on the brink of extinction gradually? That's also a question mark. If so, how do we preserve these small pockets of ancient talent is the question. Like many such, even in Karnataka, you see we do the Ganesha Puja. We also create Ganesha God. That's also made of the terracotta. Again, immersed in the water. Like many things are there. If you go on studying the entire format, it's nice to get an exhibition of this kind, which takes us to think on many more such aspects, even in Karnataka, or for that matter, anymore. Even in the Rangoli patterns, you find for every day, for Monday, there is a specific Rangoli. For a Tuesday, there is a specific Rangoli. Like that, even for a Saturday, like that. The moment you enter the house, you know whether today is which day it belongs to. And when there is no Rangoli, you know that something has gone wrong with this family. These are the symbolic the expressions that are right is in front of the house. Well, we can keep on talking about like this because the forum itself is such a beautiful one. And I once again welcome you to see all these exhibitions. Thank you, Sudhakar Rauji. And we really make it at Bharati Vidya Bhavan to make our students to come and see this exhibition on a regular basis. Possibly we put it on our calendar of events also, if things go well with the timing of the publications, so that we can share the beautiful things together. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Thank you very much for your insights, Shurishji, Joint Secretary IGNC in New Delhi, to give her notes and remarks on the exhibition.
Distinguished dignitaries on the dais and esteemed members of the audience, on behalf of Indira Gandhi National Center of Arts, Southern Regional Center and the national headquarters at New Delhi. I welcome you all to this historic occasion when NGMA and IGNCA have partnered together for the first time to bring a wonderful exhibition to the people of Bangalore. And this is a very happy occasion, and I'm sure that many more such occasions would arise in future, as Dr. Rao has just said. And this exhibition about the devotion and the terracotta offerings made to the Lord Ayanar by the rural people of Tamil Nadu is expressive of the devotion of the common man, as well as Julie Wayne, who's a photographer from the United States. She lives in France. So I would like to share this with the audience that she chanced upon the sacred groves and the Ayanar shrines far away from the villages. These are on the outskirts of the villages. And she, on her visit to Tamil Nadu, she just chanced upon these, and she was so fascinated and taken in by these that she returned next year. And for the last 10 years, she's been returning and living with the potters in their villages and participating in their fairs, the rituals. So they have almost become a part of her family. So last 10 years, she's been regularly, every year she comes to India, and she has spent time with them. So this work which you are going to see, it is also a work of devotion and offering. And it is not just a photographer going and from the external eye, he's just photographing the things. She has been part of the process with them, and the potter's families have become like her own families. And in Delhi, when she was introduced to us by the Sanskriti Foundation, so Indira Gandhi National Center of Arts, we have a Janpad Sampada division. So this division of Indira Gandhi Center, we have a rich ethnographic collection, and this has been developed as a part of our research activities carried out by the division. And we have a collection of masks, puppets, scrolls, painting, ritual objects, textiles. And the Janpad Sampada division does cross-cultural and intercultural research on folk and tribal traditions also. In IGNCA, we give equal emphasis to the classical traditions as well as the folk and the tribal traditions of art, and try to see the similarities between them and how they are affecting each other. So this Ayanar cult, when Julie presented her work, so we thought that it was a very good opportunity to bring it to the city-bred public also, and even people in Tamil Nadu may not be knowing about this cult, what to speak of people in Delhi. Though Sanskriti Foundation in Delhi, they have a museum of Indian terracotta, and they have three museums, and one is the Museum of Indian Terracotta, and they have a collection of the votive objects and the horses and the figures of the Veerans, and it's a wonderful museum there. So, but not many people know about this. So we collaborated with Julie and Sanskriti Foundation, and together we brought the exhibition to Delhi, and we also had a demonstration of the craft of the making of these huge horses, the devotion offerings, and this was a very wonderful occasion. So since we have a center in Bangalore, so we thought that this exhibition should travel particularly to the south, and Julie also wants that it should definitely go to Chennai and other places of Tamil Nadu. So I'm really happy that today we are having this exhibition in Bangalore. And on this occasion, I would just like to read out something which she has written in a book which was released at the time in exhibition of Delhi. So 5 minutes, I think, if people can give me. So I think she was not able to be here today. She's in France, but I think in the winter she'll be coming back to India again. So she writes that for hundreds of years, the village dwellers in Tamil Nadu have honored their protector god Ayanar, illustrious god in a land entrenched in deep agricultural roots. Ayanar protects villages, their cattle, and the harvest. He incites the monsoon rains, the source of life in this hot and arid land. Healer and benefactor of his devotees and granter of children to his followers, he drives away evil spirits and malevolent beings, and with his army willingly pursues anything that may interfere with the happiness and prosperity of those who revere him. His open-air shrines, frequently hidden within the sacred groves, are home to remarkable and fantastic terracotta beshcheries, the accumulation of annual offerings gifted to the great god. For each shrine, at the beginning of the summer, a meeting takes place among a group of wise men, and be priests, astrologers, village elders, to determine the date of the next festival honoring Ayanar and the other local deities associated with him. The celebrations usually take place during the hottest summer months when divine intervention is most essential. And the soil is parched, the cattle are thirsty, and the agricultural activity has slowed down significantly due to the intolerable heat. Now, once the auspicious date is decided, the potters for whom it is the hereditary charge begin to create the various clay effigies ordered by the villagers as their own individual offerings. Like ex votos, these statues make manifest the devotee's request for protection or for fulfillment of their desires or for gratitude for the wishes granted. The sculptures consist of life-sized horses, the Ayanar's mount, of cows, elephants, dogs, and snakes, and small human-like figurines also, which represent the devotees themselves. And each village also has a village offering. So the biggest horse is the collective offering of the village. So individual smaller votives are made as a personal offering, but the village gets together and orders. The first order is for the village horse. So all of these pieces are modeled, dried, fired, painted, and finally decorated during elaborate celebrations, which often last for 2 to 3 days. And the time period for preparation of the figures, the huge horses, is normally 3 to 5 weeks it takes for the preparation. So once the rituals that implore the Ayana's grace and give life to the terracotta offerings are completed, the pieces are placed in an outdoor shrine dedicated to the god. There they will stay, gradually worn by the sun and the wind, occasionally broken by joyful monkeys, inevitably eroded by the monsoon and the years that go by, and slowly with time they collapse and crumble, and like all things bound to the cycles of nature, once again they become earth and dust. Thank you.
Veenaji, for your address, it's not just the address, but it's also the expression of Ms. Julie Wayne through you. I thank once again Srimati Veena Joshi. Now I request Sri Harsha Vinay, Assistant Curator, NGMA Bangalore, to give the vote of thanks.
On behalf of NGMA Bengaluru and IGNCA Southern Regional Center, I'd first like to thank Sri Sudhakar Rao, Chairman Advisory Committee, NGMA Bengaluru, for his support, encouragement, and initiation towards holding this exhibition here, as well as accepting to inaugurate it. Thank you very much, sir. I also extend a warm gratitude to Srimati Veena Joshi, Joint Secretary, IGNCA, New Delhi, and Sri H.N. Suresh, Director, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, for being the guests of honor at the inaugural ceremony of this exhibition. IGNCA, SRC, and NGMA would like to give our thanks to Ms. Julie Wayne, curator and photographer of the exhibition, and her entire team of friends, potters, and collaborators in documenting and conceiving this very rare exhibition. Our thanks to Srimati Satyabhama Badrinath, Director, NGMA, Director NGMA Bengaluru, for her unstinted support in organizing this exhibition. Sri O.P. Jain, Founder President, Sanskriti Pratisthan, Srimati Deepali Khanna, Member Secretary, IGNCA, New Delhi, Professor Jyotinder Jain, Professor, Cultural Archives, IGNCA, New Delhi, Sri Vikram Sampath, Executive Director, IGNCA, Southern Regional Center, Bengaluru, members of the Advisory Committee, NGMA Bengaluru, and the Ministry of Culture, Government of India, for making this exhibition possible. Finally, our thanks to all the staff members at IGNCA SRC and my colleagues at NGMA Bengaluru for installing and mounting this exhibition. Thank you all. Thank you all again for coming. There will now be a formal opening of the exhibition by Sri Sudhakar Rao, Chairman, NGMA, followed by a high tea at the cafeteria. I request everyone present here to please join us at the cafe after viewing the exhibits. Hope you all had a nice evening, and hope to look forward to seeing you all again next month when we have another collaboration with IGNCA in opening another exhibition. Thank you all for coming, and hope you have a nice evening.